Charles Koch says that he now regrets spending his life creating cultural and political division in America. Lee Atwater, this is who I think of with this story. Lee Atwater had a brain tumor. Okay, Lee Atwater was the person who brought us the Reagan presidency, where he shows up in Philadelphia, Mississippi, and it's very clear. It's a presidency run of division. Lee Atwater learned under Karl Rove. He learned under Segretti. And he was kind of known as the dirty tricks guy. I mean, that was his label. He was the dirty tricks guy. Bring in Lee Atwater when we want to do a lot of horrible things. So Lee Atwater's on his deathbed, dying of a brain tumor. He says, you know what? I wish I hadn't done this. Now we have the Koch brothers. David, of course, is dead. One of the brothers is dead from cancer. And so we have another one who's living. I don't know how to take it. What is your take on what he's saying here?
No, this is absolutely Charles, who's 85 years old. You know, he's not long for this world at this point, just in a timetable stance. And he's trying to do the same thing. He wants his legacy, his brother's legacy, to be one of unity, he says, one of building bridges. Mm. And this, you know, he came out and says, wow, did we get it wrong? I think was his exact quote in this article. But
wow, did we get it wrong? This is the guy who brought us the Tea Party.
Right.
I mean, he financed everything about it. Alex, they're his, you know, across the nation, Alex has absolutely decimated decency with their legislation. They were the money from Alex. I could go on organization after organization.
Right. I mean, union busting, fracking. This guy's company is responsible for more than 300 different oil spills across the country.
One of the biggest fines in my recollection, I saw this environment, it was above $30 million, is one of the biggest environmental fines, which was still a slap on the wrist.
Right.
But there was oil everywhere. It was in the aquifer. It was everywhere. Department of Justice, as usual, does nothing. They slap him on the wrist. That's what both of these brothers have been used to over the years. You know, I got to hold out and hope for the best here, Farron. Is it reasonable to believe that he has had a change of mind, that now Charles is saying, you know, all I have is my legacy? My brothers, I wrote a book. You might remember one of the fiction books I wrote, where I took the two brothers and made them into interesting characters. Yeah. And it was easy to deal with that. He wants to change that image, doesn't he? Can he do it?
He wants to change it, but he's not actually willing to do anything to change it. Because, you know, you had brought up Georgia. Well, he is still pumping a couple million dollars into the Republicans in these runoffs, while at the same time saying, gee, partisanship is so bad, I wish I hadn't done it. But you're still doing it. You can't say you don't want to do it while you're still funding this stuff.
Governor Scott Walker, the most odious person in politics before Donald Trump. So Scott Walker is propped up by the Koch brothers for, we know, at least $3 million. It's much more than that. But he invented Scott Walker up in Wisconsin, didn't he?
He did. And Scott Walker kind of gave rise to this newer breed, I should say, of Republican, the one who went out there and wasn't afraid to go and say, the unions are evil. You know, not just, we need to get rid of, but just absolutely demonizing these organizations in a way we had not seen before. Even Reagan wasn't this overt with it. Just absolutely pushing the corporate interest without pretending that he wasn't.
Don't you get to a point where there's no return. I think that's what's happening here.